Alternative formats for this presentation can be found on the Financial Services website. For assistance, visit or contact us. Email us at finance.training@queensu.ca or give us a call at 613-533-2050. In this video tutorial, you will learn how to run the FAST Project Summary Report. The Project Summary Report displays financial information for research projects at a summary level, such as the surplus deficit, budget, revenue, expenses, commitments, and future budgets. You can run the report by project, department, or by principal investigator. To navigate to the report, you will begin on the Queen's University homepage. From there, click on the Search and Sign In button. Then choose My QueensU Solos. After entering your Queen's NetID and password and clicking Login, you will be redirected to your Queen's portal. From there, you will choose My Applications. You then have two options to access the report. You can click on the FAST link to be redirected to the FAST homepage. From there, you will select Research Reports in the menu bar at the top of your screen and select Project Summary. You can also access the report directly from the My Applications screen by selecting Project Summary under the Research Reports section. You are now at the Filter Options screen. From here, you can specify how you want to run the report by entering your filters. You can generate this report for one or more principal investigators, projects, or departments, or you can leave the filters blank and run a wide open report based on your project security. Please note the data field is a required field. If you wish to filter this report by PI, you can search by name by clicking on the magnifying glass. Enter the PI's last name and click Search. This will bring up a list of PIs that match your criteria. You may then select the PI you are looking for and click the Add button. You can filter your report using more than one PI. To add more PIs to your filter, repeat the search process. To remove any of your filters, click on them and click the red X button at the right of the filter box. To filter your report by project, enter the project number in the search field and click the green plus sign. You can filter your report by adding more than one project number. To add a project, repeat the search process. You can also search by project name by clicking on the magnifying glass, entering a keyword, and selecting the project from the list of matches that pop up. Again, you can remove the filter by highlighting it and clicking on the red X. To filter your report by department, enter the department number in the search field and click the green plus sign. You can also search by department name by clicking on the magnifying glass, entering a keyword, and selecting the department from the list of matches that appear. Again, you can remove the filter by highlighting it and clicking on the red X. Lastly, you can run the report using only the date criteria, leaving the other filter options empty, simply by clicking on the green Execute Report button on the right side of the screen. The report will run filtering on all projects that you have been granted access to. Remember that the filter trail is always visible at the top of any report, allowing you to view the filters you have selected for the report. I will now explain the different features of this particular report. The Project Summary Report contains the project number, the project title or description assigned in the finance system, the PI name, the department number and name the project is affiliated with, the related fund code, the grant or contract end date, and the status of the project. A status of A indicates the project is active, and a status of I indicates it is inactive. If you click on the project number, you can access additional information from the Track Awards module. The report will also provide you with the project spending deadline, which reflects the last date that expenses can be charged to the project. You will notice that the details in this column are color-coded. Dates which appear in green font indicate there are more than 3 months remaining before the project spending deadline. If the date appears in yellow, this indicates there are less than 3 months remaining before the project spending deadline. And finally, if the date appears in red, this indicates the project spending deadline has passed. The surplus deficit shows at a quick glance the financial position of the project. The surplus deficit column is calculated by taking the amount in the expense budget column and subtracting the amount in the expenses and commitments column. You will notice the surplus deficit column is also color-coded. Amounts which appear in green font indicate there is more than 10% of the budget remaining to be spent. Amounts which appear in yellow indicate there is less than 10% of the budget remaining to be spent. And amounts in red indicate project spending exceeds the expense budget. The commitments column represents the total commitments outstanding for the project. Commitments may include future salaries and benefits, purchase orders, travel advances, subject payment advances, graduate research assistant fellowship payments, and overhead. The expenses and commitments column represents the sum of actual expenses and commitments. The expense budget column represents the total budget to date. The revenue received column represents the revenue posted to the project from inception to date. Finally, the future budget non-overhead column represents future budgets for the project which are not yet reflected in the expense budget column. The future budget column does not include budgeted overhead. Any value on a FAST report which appears in blue font represents a hyperlink which allows you to drill down in order to access additional details. For example, if you drill down on the project number, you will access additional descriptive data from the award system, such as the awarded amount, agency and program, and the URS contact. Once you've drilled down on a value, you can always return to the original report by clicking the Return to Project Summary Back button at the top of the screen. You can drill down on actual expenses in order to access additional expense transaction details. Drill down on commitments to access additional details at the account level and by commitment type. From there, you can drill down further to view additional details, such as the payee name for salary commitments. To view budget details by year and by account, drill down on the expense budgets. In order to view details for revenue received, drill down on these totals. From there, you can drill down further to view the related journal entry details. And finally, you can drill down on totals which appear under the Future Budget Non-Overhead column in order to access future budget details by year and by date. Additional information contained in the Project Summary Report includes the finance contact name, track DSS number, and any comments that Research Accounting has entered for that particular project. How may we help you today? If you have questions, give us a call at 613-533-2050. Our fax number is 613-533-6433. Email us at finance@queensu.ca or visit the Financial Services website. We are located at 207 Stewart Street, 3rd floor in the Rideau Building. Our hours of operation are Monday to Friday from 8 a.m. to 4 p.m. This concludes our tutorial. To learn more or to review additional training resources and video tutorials, visit the Financial Services training page.